Being a sandstone, one thing you will immediately notice about Avana is its different tones and vein patterns. The randomness of these is, we think, what makes it such a striking stone.
It is inevitable that you will find a wide variation in shade, so we would always suggest that you order a decent contingency amount so that you have freedom to play with the colours. And if you are looking at ordering over 1,000 square metres, let us know how much per space, for example living room, bathroom, etc., so that we can group together the stone so that within each space you have minimum variation in tone. You will find tiny holes on the surface of Avana, which is completely normal. We don't see any need to fill them unless you're installing the tiles in a shower.
Due to the nature of sandstone, occasionally the odd corner of an Avana tile can chip during transport.
This is easily fixed with grout, which can fill any gap so that it isn't noticeable.
You may notice that when you unpack your tiles, they are damp and may seem darker than expected.
This is because we use water during their production and they are packed while they are still wet. As soon as they dry, they will revert to the normal colour. Being a natural material, the tiles won't have a uniform colour, so we suggest you choose tiles from different boxes and move them around to create the best blended effect. Avana is a porous stone, so we recommend that you apply a pre-treatment product. It's important to cover the entire tile so that no dark patches form. This means the front, the back and the sides. To ensure there is no nasty shadow effect, cover the entire tile with grout. Then make sure you wipe off any excess immediately before it can penetrate the stone and stain it. We recommend the minimum spacing possible and again, a minimum amount of grout. If you are installing it in a shower or outside where it will be exposed to water, you will need to leave some spacing and fill it with grout. If you are installing Avana in a shower or outside where it will be exposed to rain, we strongly recommend that you add a coat of water repellent product before the final treatment. This will give an extra level of waterproofing and help keep your stone looking beautiful. At the final treatment stage, we would recommend applying a coat of Filamat to provide an extra layer of protection before using Filafob. The order, in this case, would be Hydro Rep, then after 24 hours, Filamat, then after 24 hours, Filafob. If you are applying any treatment to a vertical surface, make sure you apply the product from the bottom upwards to avoid drip marks. Apply your final treatment with a brush. Wait for 5 or 10 minutes and then remove all the excess from the surface using paper towel. This way you will avoid shading or dark areas forming. If you have any questions about Avana or any Salvatori products, please visit our website or write to us.